We're gonna start with one cup of warm water in the bowl. One teaspoon of yeast. Some honey. I use agave. Actually, we're nearly out, but that's okay. Two tablespoons, but I don't really measure it. I just kind of
add it in. And
teaspoon of salt. Okay. Now stir that up. This is how the yeast grows in the water before we add the flour. And we leave it for like 10 minutes. I'm gonna cover it. Okay, so while the yeast and the water are getting all chummy and lovey and cozy together, this is what we do with the flour. It's 3.5 cups of flour.
One.
Now you have to make sure that the water is not hot, because hot water kills yeast. Warm water
makes it grow.
And obviously for pizza dough, you don't use too much yeast.
Just a little, to give it a little oomph. 3.5.
If you don't have time to do this whisking, you just put a fork into the flour and give it a little stir.
The fork kind of does the same job.
This is what we've prepared earlier. This is the water with the yeast.
You pour it into the flour so they can make friends. And become a warm, squishy dog.
Now, first I'm going to stir it until the water is kind of soaked into the flour, and then I put my hands in. I give it a good seat.
Okay, in with the hands.
Tablespoons of olive oil to it. Now this really makes a difference. Some people add the olive oil around the same time as they're mixing the water in, but I always forget to do that. So I always add it at the end, and it works a treat.
It gives the dough a lovely texture afterwards. Looking good. All these ingredients are making friends together. This dough is ready to cover. Make a little ball of it. A rough little ball, more like a brain. Here you go, little brain. I'm gonna leave it for 2 hours while I make the sauce. For the sauce, we're gonna need some onions. I like these red onions, I find them really tasty. Some nice tomatoes. I use organic because they taste better and you don't really get those fish chemicals in them. Some nice garlic. I use agave instead of honey. I'm just gonna put a little bit in. And a little bit of balsamic vinegar. Some passata. And olive oil, of course. There we go. Okay.
I generally just take all the ends off first.
I've often wondered how other people do this. How do people chop garlic? Well, I always work with them as a team. I don't do each bit separately, you know? And for a sauce like this, I really like to use quite a bit. You know, you don't have to use a garlic at all. I just like it. And it really does add a nice flavor to the tomato sauce.
Some people leave these green things in,
but I don't like them. Okay, we want to use a little olive oil. Well, a nice amount. Garlic. I use 5 to 7 cloves. Onion. Now, I'm gonna let that. Got some new agave. Put a little bit in there. Balsamic vinegar. A couple of capfuls, maybe 3. Mix it all up.
It's very soft in there. Everything's well cooked. It's only been about 20 minutes or so on a low heat, but it's cooked beautifully.
I'm going to add lots of tomato puree. Passata.
Yeah,
organic.
It's literally
just tomatoes. Might have to do all of this here. Gonna mix it.
You can put it rough on the pizza, it doesn't have to be, but I like it smooth, so I mix it.
Ta-da! So I've left the dough in here for a few hours, and yes, it's all risen. Check that out. And now I have to flatten it. A little sprinkling of flour over it. And I'm going to take a ball for rolling.
So I'm going to cut the dough to the size of the tin. I just measure it like this. Use a knife.
And it's ready to go in the tin. Maybe I could take a little bit off the edge here. So it's a little bit wonky, but that's okay. I roll up the rest of the dough and put it back in
to roll another pizza. Now this can be quite tricky.
Because if it's too thin, it might break. Hopefully it's okay. Yeah, this looks okay. But I like to roll it as thin as I think it can go. And if it's a little bit funny, I just straighten it out, just like this. But it's nice and stretched and thin.
Oh, and I cut that paper because I feel it's like the best way to have it cooking. Now we're ready for our sauce.
I like to go right to the edge. I don't like too much of an edge on my pizza.
Hungry?
Some people like a thicker pizza dough, so you can roll it thicker. It doesn't have to be so thin. Some people like a tiny bit of tomato sauce. I like a good bit, but not so it's dripping. Just a nice amount. Some parmesan. Mushroom. Bon appétit.